Welcome to The Snapshot, our series which examines the forces shaping and driving global commodities markets today. On-purpose benzene production via conversion from toluene now makes economic sense after almost 2 years of negative margins, S&P Global Platts data shows. For most of this year, the European benzene market has been under pressure due to oversupply. In June, however, three styrene plants and two phenol plants in Europe returned from maintenance, and in July, benzene prices surged. Little or no imports arrived in June either, so at the end of July, benzene's premium to its feedstock naphtha hit a 12-month high of nearly $400 per metric ton. A close relative of benzene, toluene, is a widely used chemical with an array of industrial applications, as well as acting as feedstock to the production of consumer products. One of the main applications of toluene is conversion to benzene, which has historically been a more valuable molecule. Toluene can be converted to benzene via several processes, but as a rule of thumb, a margin of $200 per metric ton between the two products is needed for the conversion to break even economically. A large part of European toluene to benzene conversion capacity is integrated into larger facilities. Since crude oil prices started their downwards trajectory in the third quarter of 2014, the spread between benzene and toluene has mostly been well below the needed $200 per metric ton mark, until now. Toluene prices performed strongly in the same period compared to the hydrocarbon complex in general. As oil prices fell, gasoline demand, particularly in the United States, surged. Toluene can be used as a gasoline blending component due to its high octane rating. This caused refiners, blenders, and traders to scramble for octanes. As a result, the toluene spot market, in Europe at least, was completely dictated by gasoline prices as chemical buyers were pushed out. However, since late July this year, the benzene premium to toluene has remained steadily above the $200 per metric ton mark, a contrast to the previous 2 years before that. European toluene prices have come under pressure due to the global gasoline market taking a bearish turn in the second quarter of this year. Following a bumper 18 months for gasoline sellers, the market reached saturation as demand growth slowed down and inventories stacked up. Benzene prices in Europe have also remained robust for most of the third quarter, as cross-regional arbitrages into Europe were seen as not very attractive towards the end of the second quarter. Looking at the fourth quarter, there seems to be a case for a sustained, healthy spread between toluene and benzene in Europe. Gasoline demand and gasoline blend volume will go lower in the fourth quarter, in line with seasonal trends and specification changes. As for benzene, a plethora of styrene turnarounds in Asia may stifle imports of both benzene and styrene to Europe from the US, as Asia is likely to provide a better netback for US styrene exports compared to Europe, and styrene run rates are likely to be high in the US as a result. This means Europe will be on its own when it comes to styrene, which could result in robust benzene demand in Europe. Until next time on The Snapshot, we'll be keeping an eye on the markets.